This paper's contribution is more or less like a position paper that it has two main elements. It has a reflection element, a reflection component, about what is happening with the technology we use in education. And finally, it ends with a proposal that has been submitted to our education ministry, like a project that is evaluating right now. We have worked long time ago about different kinds of technology, components, tools that could be interesting to introduce in education. Because we know that the current society we live need this kind of technology support. We have used some kind of mantra technology like learning management systems that are the deeply introduced in the especially higher education, but also in companies. And perhaps we use or we adopt the ways we teach in our usual practice with this kind of tools. On the other hand, there are also other components, tools, innovations that are appearing in the context of our society, and we use if we want, but this kind of tools are not usually recognized as official learning tools by our institutions. Then we have a gap that was in the previous presentation. We use for our life, for our personal learning, for our work, tools that are not recognized. And we have to do that, we have to challenge a challenge in order to break these rules. Perhaps looking for more breaking ideas like what Francisco Michavila explained as active education, to give the opportunity to people to be more involved in the learning processes. Then, it's a fact, the application of ICT is a reality, and technology gives us more opportunities for education. Then, when we are in the reflection about what's happening with technology in education, we usually work research in educational methods, perhaps from a more pedagogical point of view, or what's happening with the technology. And sometimes, researchers from here do not mind what's happening here. And on the contrary, research here doesn't mind what's happening here. It's like a reverse. Then perhaps conference like this want to join all point of views in the same table, the same room, and was talking about what's happening. Thus, the context we have is we have an increasing presence of open educational resources. This is a fact that is changing the reality and the choice we have. Now we have several sources, several resources, and a teacher is no more the only source of knowledge. Also, as I said, the e-learning platforms, the official e-learning platforms, are not currently the only educational content in this realm of education. There are too many possibilities. And the topic of this track, they are perhaps because of the technology integration in the learning processes, there is a diffuse frontier between the formal and informal learning processes. Then, some years ago, perhaps, talking about informal was not too much important, as informal was informal conversations in a physical way. However, we can have social communications, transferring knowledge with potential lot of people around the world through the technology. Then we have to break the technology and the methodological elements in education, because we have to include all these possibilities, and we have to do with the option to make flexible, to make free for the institutions, because if we have the same platform, we have to adopt this platform in every way. However, if we have the freedom to choose what elements are the most interesting for me as an institution or for me as a teacher, is another situation. Technological and methodological. Then we talk about a new perspective, a new orientation of technology that is called, like an abstraction, is technological learning ecosystems. It's a concept that goes beyond of fashionable technology. It's a concept that you can introduce in your institution with the aim of evolve as the evolution of your needs regarding the place. Then, a technological ecosystem is based on the concept of biological ecosystem. It's a community of living things whose vital processes are interrelated and whose development depends on the physical characteristics of the environment. Then it's easy to translate this metaphor to the educational process. Thus, we have a very important challenge to construct this metaphor, to build up this metaphor. Because talking about that we have several different components that are interesting for me, and the most significant elements to having all together is easy to express, but so difficult to introduce it as a real possibility in the classroom. Because you need to have the interoperability capability of all of these components. Then this element is a very important issue just in order to make real this metaphor, this interesting idea in the current practice of our learning processes. And if we have this, then I have to introduce a methodological line, just in order to fully practice. Then, if we want to discuss, if we want to make this like a real educational component of resources, we have to work in two different technological paths. We need an architectural work framework just in order to plug in the components we like in our educational frame, and on the other hand, the components we need. Then, at this moment, several research groups in Spain that we have together or not using different aspects of the technological part of the education, the personal processes, we identify four components to start to construct this frame, this technological ecosystem. The analytics, because we need to know what is happening. One of, I don't know if you are real or not, but if you are in a virtual environment, all you can do is store it in the system. And you can analyze what is happening. Then, if we have several different possibility of interaction, we have to gather all the data that is creating, is appearing in this new environment. Other important issue is the adaptation. If we have advanced technology, we may use it just in order to teach each student what he or she needs, no, instead of giving all them the same materials, content, activities, independently of the learning style they have or the capabilities they have. Then, adaptation is very important. It's not another important issue that we want to have in this technological ecosystem. So interesting and so related with informal learning. Games. Games-based learning is so important, so interesting, especially for youngest students, but in other, I think in all studies of the education. Then we can use this data and this adaptivity capabilities just in order to create, from a pedagogical point of view, gamified processes that could be supported by the technological ecosystem. And the last part is so related with the previous presentation, is the semantic portfolio, because we need the evidence. We have to gather not the interaction type data, we need to gather the learning outcomes of the practices. We start with architectural pattern that tries to introduce or support all of this stone with a very important layer that is here is regarding the human computer interaction, because learning is an interactive process and we need to take into account the way that the people is interacting with the system. The services that we are offering, just in order to introduce here this abstraction of component of 2.0 tools, whatever we need regarding the previous element. We need to manage data to support process of decision making, and we have a lower infrastructure just in order to user management, have the interoperability capabilities and so on. And this is not only for a technological approach. We need a management approach, because we need to introduce also the institution point of view. It depends if a university, a school, or an enterprise. You have to make decisions about your learning processes, because you are managing your knowledge. And we have to introduce also the pedagogic part with the creating methodologies that use this kind of thing. The components I talk about, if you want to talk to make any question, I will be able to. Then, the conclusion of this position paper is this proposal has this cornerstone at the starting point, the platform as the only component of the strategy for educational and technological innovation, or a strategy for effective knowledge management is no longer. The idea is we have to change the technological background in our educational processes. This does not mean that this kind of platforms should not be sent into Orion, but it's absolutely necessary to integrate this platform in this framework, like another component, not like the only one. We have named this framework as technological learning ecosystem. This framework must give support to renewed educational processes where adaptability and any context of learning need is a characteristic and not just something to wish for. The ecosystem must give response to the technology and knowledge management strategy within any institution that deploys, and also have space to grow, evolve, and adapt dynamically to the institution business and educational requirements. This is the most outstanding element of our proposal, because here are the most important technological challenges. We have to support the business with the possibility to grow and evolve, and this is not easy. Then, this is more or less the structure of our proposal that reflects the architectural pattern that I presented some slide before, with the interactive layer with the different kind of users we have. We have a data loop just in order to have a semantic representation of all data we manage, and we have different kinds of work package project that tries to give a response in the previous element. We have a proposal of a kit of architectural framework. This is responsibility of Salamanca University. We have another work package that is related to analytics, that is represented by one group in Technical University of Madrid and also University of Zaragoza. This is about gamification, that is supported by a research group in the University of Alicante, and this is the portfolio part of the ecosystem that is supported by UPC with Nico's work, Mark and Ring. We have called this idea, and we would like that our ministry likes the proposal.